Hello children, welcome for the video lesson session 3. I think all of you are ready with your ebooks and also the running notes ready with you, having a pen in your hands. Before we get into today's session, let's quickly go with the recap of the other day's session. I have already introduced the lesson, which is The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov. And it was an extract taken by a diary entry made by Margie, 11 years old girl, on the date. Please keenly observe the date, children. It was mentioned on 17th of May 2157. And also I have introduced two characters on day 1, two more characters on day 2 as well. So please give a glance at the characters also. One is Margie. 2 is Tommy, 3 is Mrs. Jones, 4 is the county inspector. So let's quickly recap the characters there. Margie was a young girl who was 11 years old girl. And whereas Tommy, he was 13 years old boy. And both of them used to attend the mechanical schools in their respective houses. Who was Mrs. Jones then? Mrs. Jones was none other than Margie's mother. And who was county inspector and how does he look? County inspector was the inspector who used to assess and rate the academic skills of the child, and also he is the one to test even the mechanical teacher and adjust the speed of the machine also. Then how does he look? There is a special description given by Margie about the county inspector. He was a round shaped man, stout, short, having red-eyed face. So maybe she hated him. That's the reason why she called. And also we have learned that she calls her computer monitor black, big and ugly. Then also we have come across the reason what could have made Margie say that. Because it was nothing, as she used to get low scores in her geography lessons and she was asked to give her tests many a times, which made her to hate the subject and also her regular teacher. I'm using the word regular teacher, children. Regular teacher is nothing but her mechanical teacher. Then the lesson was stating all about the interaction between Margie and Tommy. They were going on talking about, as Tommy found a book in his attic, which was all about a school, and it was the book of his grandfather's grandfather. Then the conversation started by looking at the book, and they have even described the book as yellow colored and crinky, and we have discussed all those things in the other day's session as well, right? Then as Margie was much more curious to know about the school and schooling and the students, because she was wondering to know that mechanical teacher never used to teach in the respective houses of the children, but all the children were assembled in one particular place and they were sent to their regular and respective classes where a human teacher used to teach them, and the curriculum was same for the whole of level of one particular class, which was amazing for Margie, and she wanted to know much more about it. But whereas she heard her mom calling saying that it's time for her to attend her regular school. Now let's see what would be the scene at her regular school. That is nothing but her study room. Shall we all carry on? So please all of you look into your books, children. Then Margie said to Tommy, "Can I read the book some more with you after school?" Then what was the response given by Tommy? He said, maybe, because he wasn't sure. Because once the interest is lost, it's lost forever. That's how he thought about Margie. Then Margie went into the schoolroom. It was right next to her bedroom. So schoolroom is nothing but, as I said, children, we can call it as a study room, which was just next to her bedroom. And the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. So mechanical teacher was nothing other than a computer, a monitor, as already we have learnt about. So as soon as she got into her room, she could see the monitor being switched on and waiting for her to attend her lessons of that day. It was always on at the same time every day. except Saturday and Sunday. So by this we understand they work five days a week. So Monday to Friday, she needs to attend her regular classes at the same time of each one of the days, from Monday to Friday. So weekends were holidays for her. So it was fixed so that automatically the computer will get switched on at the same time every day from Monday to Friday. And the only thing what Margi had to do is she needs to just sit in front of the monitor and attend the classes. Now I'll show you the picture, children. You all please can keenly observe the picture which is in your textbook. Can you all see Margi sitting in front of the system and working on it, listening to the lecture as well? Yes. So this is the scene of her regular classroom. Because her mother said little girls learn better if they learned at regular hours. So they have even reasoned it out that why the particular time is fixed every day from Monday to Friday. It was Mrs. Jones, that is Margie's mother, who said so that if a particular slot is booked and fixed for one of the childs to learn about it, then it's better. That's how the time is fixed. The screen was lit up and it said, "Today's arithmetic lesson is on the addition of proper fractions. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot." So as soon as Margi was ready, sitting in front of the system, and as the system could observe, the student is very much ready. Immediately the screen lit up, so light could be seen, switched on, and it started saying what that day's lesson was all about, the additions of proper fractions. You all know proper and improper fractions will be there in arithmetic mathematics, right? So that day's topic was all about addition and proper fractions. Then before it would like to start its lecture, she was wanting Margi to submit her homework. What was it is wanting? It is wanting her homework to be submitted in the proper slot. Because it is nothing but a computer, then she needs to submit and press the submit button. Then Margi did so with a sigh. S-I-G-H, the word sigh is used. Sigh is nothing but, you know, it is a gesture of showing displeasure. Because she was not doing anything willingly. She was not wanting at all to attend the regular classes of her mechanical teacher any a time. And that too she hates doing homework, as already we have learnt about her. Then when she was insisted, when she was compelled to submit her homework, she did with no expression, and also she was, you know, giving the gesture as if she was completely unhappy and disappointed. She was thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. As she was doing her work of submission of homework and listening to the lecture given by the mechanical teacher, she was thinking about her grandfather's grandfather and his school days and his friends and his books. So it means usually sometimes, you know, these kind of people are called what? Body is present and mind is absent. So Margi was physically present there, but her thoughts were lingering around only her grandfather's school days, because they were sounding to be very interesting, as Tommy told everything about such kind of new things to Margi. And all the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom. So then she started recollecting the description what Tommy has given, why he was reading the book sitting with Margi. Then she was recollecting, oh my god, such a lovely schooling environment there. All the kids, they come running to the school, then they'll disperse to their respective classes with a happy mood, and as they keep moving to school and their classrooms, they will talk to each other, they'll discuss so many things, how happy they were. This was all the things, like, you know, she was just thinking. Then she also said they sit together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day. Not only they only go together to the classrooms, but also as soon as the school hours are done, they would also disperse to their own respective houses, having a talk in a group they move. And they learn the same things. Another wonderful thing what she was thinking about, sitting in a group as a good number in one of the classes, learning the same thing, having a good discussion among the children, was something she found it very interesting. So they could help one another with the homework and talk about it. Children, please keenly observe and you underline this sentence as well in your textbook. So they could help one another, because Margi was such a child who used to find her homework to be done by herself, which was difficult, she felt so. Then she exclaims and she states here, oh, they might have been given a chance to discuss and also help each other to complete their home task also. How good things they were taught. They were given a chance to do it. So sharing is caring. So that's what she was thinking all about. And the teachers were people. Ultimately and finally, she states here that the teachers were people. Because poor thing Margi, if at all you empathize, you put your feet in her shoes. If you put yourself in the position of Margi, and if you were Margi, how would you think you would really come to know about? She was stating that, oh my God, the teachers were the people there, the human beings, because she has a lot of problem with her mechanical teacher. Now when she's thinking about all these things and when she's recollecting all these things, what are been told by Tommy to Margi, could the mechanical teacher notice what was she thinking? No. Then what would the mechanical teacher do this particular time when she was thinking? It keeps on teaching because it is, and after all, a machine which would not notice any emotions of the person who is sitting, which would not see the person who is sitting also. That's how even Margi also could think of all these things, recollecting all the things. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen. Meanwhile, she could see something flashing on the screen. When we add fractions, half and quarter. So it means the mathematics lecture was going on. As that day's topic was all about what, children? It was all about additions of proper fractions. Then maybe the computer teacher, that is mechanical teacher, was teaching her to add 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 is equal to what? Then as soon as she heard that, then she was disturbed from what she was thinking all about from. Then Margi was thinking about how the kids must have loved it in the old days. She was thinking about the fun they had. So she would conclude her diary entry of that day stating that, oh my God, now again I got a call from my mechanical teacher where I could see her teaching me very mechanically without letting the machine know whether I'm understanding or not. It is going on teaching. Then she concludes saying that, oh, how happily they used to spend their time in olden schools where the children used to go together. Work also used to get it done with having a lot of children along, and home tasks also they used to have a lot of sharing done. They used to discuss and do it. While coming to school, they used to come in group. While going home, they used to maintain the groups. All these things, you know, she was thinking so, and she commented saying, what? Oh my God, what sort of fun they had. So what is the name of our lesson? The fun they had. This is how she had ended up the letter. I hope, children, all of you might have understood the lesson. And let me just quickly tell you all about the writer Isaac Asimov. He is a very popular writer who usually writes all his write-ups about the science and fiction. So always he would make some interesting stories based on science and fiction. So this is also such kind of a thing. If given a chance to board into a time machine, that's how I started the lesson, if you remember. And if you go to the 2157th year, then you may see these kind of things. Let's just quickly look at the picture where they have given several methods of learning. Please look at this picture once again, children. These are the several methods which may be seen in the year 2157. I hope all of you might have understood it. And as I said before, as soon as we conclude any of the things, you will be served with a worksheet and you will all need to do attempt. And also there are certain questions here under the comprehension. Please look at the comprehension as well, children. There are certain questions given here. Try to even attempt them also. Try to even how better and how good you all can just attempt all these questions. Apart from the worksheet what I serve you, you will need to even go ahead with. Like there are certain questions, you know, they are asking you, how old are Margi and Tommy? I just mentioned on the very first day, Margi is 11 years old. Tommy was, how old was he? He was 13 years old. What did Margi write in her diary? It is in the very much in the first sentence only. What best you all can do is, read the lesson once again before you comprehend. It's given clearly that it's all about a real book. So what did she write in her diary entry? It was all about real book. Had Margie ever seen a book before? No, she might have not seen. Otherwise, why would she be so amazed by looking at the book? So she hadn't seen. What things about the book did she find strange? You can mention about the letters slanting straight. They are slanting, they are straight, and they are standing at one particular place without moving. Another thing is, when they turn back to the page, they could see the same matter existing. That was also another thing which she found it. And another thing is getting it printed on paper. So all these three things you can mention in that. Then what do you think a telebook is? Tele is nothing but telephone, you all know it. Telebook is nothing but reading the book online, like ebook you can call it as. Then where was Margie's school? Did she have any classmates? Where was her school children? It was nothing but another separate room which was just next to her bedroom. So in that room there is a mechanical teacher, that's nothing but a computer sitting. Does she have any classmates? No, she was all alone attending her classes. What subjects did Margie and Tommy learn? They haven't told about or listed about many of the subjects here. They just have mentioned about geography and mathematics. So we shall also answer the same way that yes, they might have been learning what? Mathematics and geography. So similarly, there are many more questions, children. So what I suggest is, please go through the whole lesson, sitting calm, then try to comprehend all the questions. Then in the next session, we shall start another new lesson. So this is Vijaya signing off. See you all and meet you all in the next session. Thank you so much.